Good morning and welcome to the Perkins Garages YouTube channel for a Ford Tourneo Custom Shuttle walk around video. But before we get started, if you are enjoying our content, hit on the subscribe button and never miss a walk around from us ever again. So this here is a frozen white Ford Tourneo Custom 9-seater Shuttle L2 featuring the 2-litre EcoBlue engine producing 130 PS of power transmitted to the front wheels through a 6-speed manual gearbox. We are registered on a 2022 registration, meaning we're taking Ford warranty with us until May 2025. The vehicle has done just under 11,000 miles, I believe it's 10,900, but I'll get the exact mileage once you're on the dashboard in a moment. So sit tight and let me walk you around this beautiful frozen white 9-seater shuttle. So to begin, we are going to arrive at the near side front bumper. I present to you in all the beautiful glory, the remote central locking key. Clicking on the unlock button in turn will wake up the daytime running lights. So a quick disclaimer, they're gonna be flashing in your video simply because the frequency in which my camera records at, but let me assure you, they're not a strobe light upgrade. They just give you the ultimate visibility no matter the lighting condition. So we have some fantastic headlights complemented with front fog lights, and just below the fog lights we can see we have front parking sensors trailing across that bottom lip of the bumper. We can see we've got the beautiful chrome front grille there as well, and just below it we have the black trims around there. So that is the part of the colorway. So we have the black trims with the frozen white, and it looks a really nice colorway. So we'll come to that in just a second, but as we are at the offside front wheel now, we're going to give you a tour around there. So we have Goodyear tires, efficient grip on there as standard. Again, they're in very good conditions. We left one ajar for you to have a look at, but these are 16 inch steel wheels, and you've got some lovely silver sparkle covers over the front of them. So taking a step back now, starting to move around the body of the vehicle, we have the security locks on the driver's door there. We have entry points on the near side and on the off side of the vehicle, so the passengers can gain entry to the rear in whatever door is safer. So we're going to start to turn the camera around now, because this stage of the video I give you a quick assessment of the body. So again, we're looking at the offside. So I'm going to start the camera nice and high up and just gently rock that down the offside of the body of the vehicle, hopefully showing you just how beautiful all the body panels are. So we have side steps on the near side and the offside. So if it's the smaller people of this world, you've got to get into the vehicle, they can use the side step to do so. So then we'll just spin that round and just show you the offside rear wheel and give you a good look at that. Now making our way around the rear of the vehicle, this one has rear parking sensors to complement the front parking sensors, and they're on that bottom lip just there. We'll come back to that in just a second, because we're going to do the exact same treatment on the near side before we progress. So starting nice and high, just gently rocking the camera. Unfortunately it's a bit shadier this side, so we don't get the full advantage of all the light. Hopefully that gives you a good idea of how beautiful it is. So this is now the near side rear wheel, and then we can follow the sidestep and the trim all the way to the near side front wheel and give you a good look at that. Okay, so let's start off by showing you inside the passenger door whilst I'm here. So again, the interior for the 9 seats, it's a lovely dark charcoal interior. You've got the lighter grey chessboard pattern in the middle. These front 2 seats are heated, which I shall come back to once I'm in the driver's seat in a moment. But we have a manually controlled seat, so we have a front height adjustment, a height for the seat, and a rear tilt is found just behind it. Before I do so, I mentioned this vehicle is an EcoBlue engine, and EcoBlue means it has an AdBlue system. So AdBlue can be found at any petrol station, even in B&Q Homebase sell it these days, and it's a bit like topping up your screen wash. You get an indicator on the dashboard so you always know when you need to fill it up, but we do this on a used car prep, so this would be full on the point of purchase of the vehicle. And what AdBlue does, it sprays a solution onto the exhaust gases, making it a nice clean burn, meaning your exhaust gases are with a lower amount of nitrous oxide, which is a harmful gas. We don't want that. We need to be nice and clean to the environment. Okay, so opening up the near side sliding door now, and we can start to look at the rear seats. So we have 7 seats in the rear of this one. We have 2, 2, and a bench of 3 at the back. So please note the first row of 2 are both ISO fixing seats. So you can clip the kiddie seats in there, keeping those kiddie seats nice and secure as you're going along. Into the second row now, we have another ISO fixing seat on the left-hand rear. So there's three ISO fixings in total, but another lovely Banker 2. I'll just jump inside and we'll go and look at the rear. So there's a bench seat of three in the rear there. Left-hand side is a 12-volt socket as well. That'll keep all your devices nicely charged up. We have lovely cubby holes for all your maybe lunch boxes with drinks holders, two USB ports on the near side of the vehicle, with two more over on the offside trim just there. Okay, just take my leaf out. Have a little hoover after I'm done. Okay, so that's inside the rear there. So you've got lovely speakers in the roof as well there, speaker system, and obviously your rear lighting as well. May glow very brightly in the darkness. Okay, so that's inside the near side. So back to the rear of the vehicle. Underneath the rear bumper is a full-size spare with all relevant tools and jacks supplied underneath the driver's seat to change a tire on the side of the road. So hopefully that might save the day. So as you can tell, we don't really have much of a boot, but I thought I'd open it anyway because you can still gain entry and maybe put some bags under the seats there. Maybe PE kits. This is going to be a school bus. I just don't know. Possibilities are endless. So just thought I'd show you under there, and have you got a nice little cubby hole to the near side. So obviously this is this 9-seater shuttle bus, so we've got 7 seats in the rear there. The other format is the Tourneo Custom Sport, which has two banks of 3 but only 8 seats, so it's a different format altogether. In the Sport obviously you get a bit of a boot space, but in this one, this is a people carrier shuttle, so that is why you do not. Beautiful. So let's just go have a quick look on the near side sliding door quickly. So again, you can gain entry from either side, but again, you've got some lovely seats there, two ISO fixings there as well. On the back of the handbrake, two more USBs. So 2, 4, 6, we're at 6 USBs for 7 seats, so hopefully that will negate some arguments on those longer journeys. Opening up the driver's door now. On the driver's door card, we have the front two electric window controls, folding mirror controls, and the electric mirror adjusts on that little wheel there. Interior locking can be found just left of the door handle. Beautifully designed door card there. This might sound silly, but you know, if you're driving around, you need something to put your wallet, your lunchbox, you might need your big drinks bottle, coffee cup. We've got loads and loads of choices for storage in this vehicle in the front. I'm going to show you quickly. Underneath this cover here is the jack and all the relevant tools required to change the spare wheel. Spinning the camera around now for the last time to show you the front two seats. Again, we've done the passenger one already. A lovely dark charcoal with a cross chest pattern in the middle, which is a lighter grey. Manual controls, which are the same as I've demonstrated on the near side. Okay, I'm just going to jump inside the vehicle now. You may hear a little bit of distortion on my microphone, so please just bear with me for a moment. Okay, thank you for your patience. To begin, obviously we have a key blade, and that goes straight in the ignition barrel. Foot depressed on the clutch. Oh, steering lock is on. Apologies. There we are. Turn the key. Gains us power to the vehicle. Okay, so to begin with the interior tour, we're going to be looking at the gauges. So again, we have a little driver display in the middle. Oh, let me just turn the heating down. So I'm going to be controlling that little screen in the middle using the return, the OK, the up and down, and the menu button on the right hand side. So to begin with, on the left hand side of the dashboard there is an RPM times 1000. That counts the revolutions of the engine. In the middle, we have a coolant temperature sensor, we have a fuel gauge, and the right hand side, an analog speedo with miles per hour around the outside and kilometers an hour in the middle. At the bottom there, that little red light is a handbrake warning sign. In the top section on the digital driver display, we can currently see the mileage. So the mileage on this vehicle is 10,933.3 to be exact. As you can see, currently we're looking at a seatbelt warning sign, and you can see all the seats displayed on there. So we've got different trip computers, we've got fuel consumption, distance till empty, instantaneous fuel consumption, we have a digital speedo on there as well, engine start stop, vehicle's charging currently. Different tyre pressure monitors on there as well. If you click the menu button, it comes up with your different settings. You can adjust the display to your preferences. We have hill start assist in the driver assistance pack. coming down once more. We have computer one reset, different maintenance screen in there. So like I said earlier, you can see your AdBlue range, you know exactly when that needs to be topped up. AdBlue level in there as well. So max refill is 14 liters and min refill is 5. AdBlue information, there we are. So it even comes up with a little graph as well, so you know exactly. Obviously this will be filled on prep as well. There we go. So you've got lots of goodies on there. So coming out of your little display there. So coming out of that display, on the right hand side, to clarify, we have all the arrows and everything like that. Below is a voice command button. We have a pickup, decline, previous and next song function there. The left hand side is where you'll find your cruise control settings. So it's nice and easy to set your speed limiter to take on and off a standby, cancel and set your speed up and down there, with resume found in the middle. On the bottom cluster here, we have a volume minus, a volume plus, and also a mute button as well. Turning that, we have indicators on the left-hand side with your full beams, and obviously your wipers are found on the right-hand side. Before we progress into the middle compartment, I just want to show you a few little cubby holes. We have a nice little document holder there. Underneath this one here will be another USB and a 12-volt socket. So that's going to be keeping all of your devices nicely charged up. So to clarify, 3 12 volts, and we've got 8 USB-A ports. USB-A ports deliver 2.1 amps of charging. A little bit of useless information for you there, guys. That's what I deliver. Okay, in the center compartment, we have two adjustable cup holders. We have a nice little sliding cover as well to close it all up afterwards. 12 volt and another USB port. This is the controls for the 6-speed manual gearbox. Very positive sensation. Lovely. In front of that is the 4-way hazard lights. And all the heating controls are found just in front of it. So we have fan speed to the left, temperature control to the right, so hot and cold. Heated front seats, which are 3-way adjustable there, so do suffer with a cold bottom, warm yourself up. We have different flows of vents to the middle, recirculation, rear demist, and on and off just at top left. Above it, we have the lovely radio display there. So to begin with, we have 6 favorites on either side, so you can program the radio to store your preferences in there. To begin with, if we click on the radio button, this will open up different sources. So we have AM, FM, FM2, DAB1, DAB2, so a whole range of all different sources. We have phone connectivity via Bluetooth, so that is your audio and also your phone connection. So those are kind of two peas in a pod, really. There we go to mobile apps, so you can add a device and find mobile apps via there. Got different different infotainment settings there, such as traffic announcement. You know, you've got your Bluetooth, mobile apps, and other goodies in there. I just want to show you as well, we do have automatic system updates and a voice control on there as well. So that's lovely. You can click the voice command button and say some simple commands to the vehicle. So lots to go out there. And also, when you pop the vehicle into reverse, that activates the front and rear parking sensors. So as you can see, we have the little proximity sensor there, so you get a little color band as you get closer to the object, front or rear. It also gives you an intermittent beep that will increase in frequency as you get closer to the object. Pop it back into neutral, just so I don't forget. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you did have any questions, please give us a call, 01376 550 899. Any questions, leave them in the comment section below. Please like, subscribe, and I shall speak to you very soon. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye for now.